horsepower.
We got a complete paint scheme. We should probably show them.
All right, let's do it.
Let's do it.
Where's your block bed?
Celtics.
Gonna close it out tonight.
Close it out because I want to be on the blog.
Out of my posse in New York. Yeah. Embarrassing, man.
Blog against blog.
We did the Jimmy Fallon show.
Oh, great.
Keep rolling on this story.
Okay.
Actually, let's say it on our own. Don't worry about
Jimmy Fallon show in New York.
Put it on national TV.
And my entourage got slapped around by Kim Cattrall's entourage from Sex and the City.
That was only one of them.
Embarrassing. If you would have, Elliot almost made Elliot cry.
I did cry. I woke up in cold sweats. If you would have saw her, you wouldn't have done the show.
Hey, how you doing? Freaking crying. Deleting stuff off his camera.
Deleting phone numbers off my phone. I gave her my wallet.
Jim Byrne wasn't helping.
Jim Byrne stepped back.
I did. Nice. What's up, dude? Hey, Dan.
How you doing, man?
Good. Nope.
Hey, Dan. Get a picture with him.
What's up, buddy?
This is my son, Dana.
Let's do it.
Starting now!
intense, man. I didn't realize you were trying to drag me on stage. I was just like, well, next thing I'm in the middle of
I said, follow me. I said, stay right with me.
I thought you meant, like, to get me past the freaking.
No, no. Kurt wanted you up there to really feel it. You want to feel it, man? Fucking right there on that stage.
I mean, I sat right below you and I felt it. I was good.
Were you on stage during the wings?
No, I tried to get him up there, but he wouldn't come up.
He wouldn't go up? Kind of a fucking reporter
he is.
This dude went to war zones, bro. This guy's in Afghanistan right now.
I didn't understand what was
fucking
going
reporter.
On. He was like, stay with me.
Do you want to be a fucking reporter?
And next thing I'm like, wait, I'm not going on
it's
stage.
It's the reporter right version of the Dana White Ultimate Fighter speech. Do you want to be a fucking reporter?
I'm a feature writer, man.
What's the difference?
Yeah. I'm over here doing a story in Afghanistan, but I'm not going out there.
That's hilarious.
Yeah.
In Afghanistan from Paris.
This dude's right now swimming in the Gulf trying to do a story on the oil spill. And you're like, no, I don't want to go on stage.
Is Ellie going to
Afghanistan? Well, I don't want to become part of the story. Journalism 101.
Probably. Joe's going. We're making Joe go.
He thinks. All of a sudden, my phone doesn't work. My agent's calling. Dana's fucking emailing me. Trying to find me on Facebook. Where is he?
Yeah, find like Tropical Thunder.
Yeah.
That actor that's over there stuck in his agent trying to get him.
What is
there'll
that?
There'll be rumors that'll come out and shit. We're going to the Middle East and doing a fight. Okay, he'll call me and go, Fries, are we going to the Middle East? Is that true? I'm like, yeah. He's like,
that's right. When you put out a comedy CD called Shiny Happy Jihad, you tend to get a little touchy about visits to the Middle East.
Balfour.
Hey. Cabo, he's building
a beach in
Petrograd.
Wonderful.
He said Cabo is the best place
on getting healed pretty good. So my left can be as strong as before.
You're a
stronger.
Stronger.
Than
better.
Stronger.
Faster.
I drive down my fucking
VitoDolphin.com.
Crazy for you or what?
Oh, it's awesome.
Yeah. Not trying.
It's awesome.
So cool.
Yeah.
I was in here. Did you go to the weigh-ins?
No, I was signing for you guys.
I'm telling you right now, in my history of being in the fight business, I've never seen a fucking weigh-in that big. I went to Game of Thrones. I live most of his accomplishments. How are you doing?
Good, buddy. How you doing?
Good. Ready? Thanks for coming.
Oh, okay.
9 championship fight wins. He tied with Randy Couture for the most ever. 5 knockout wins in a championship fight, which actually is tied with Chuck Liddell for the most ever. And there's about 50 other things on here that I won't bore you with. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the greatest fighters of all time, one of the greatest welterweights ever, and one of the greatest human beings you could ever meet who helped us build this sport and business, Matt Hughes!
Wouldn't be where we're at today without you guys, there's no doubt about that. The whole Fan Expo going on here, the UFC selling out most every event they've got. I mean, to be honest, it's you guys that paid that admission to write my check. So I gotta take my hat off to you guys. Thank you guys. So.